Well, today I am not going to be preparing anything in the kitchen. I have got special guests, Amanda and Barry Franks, the owners and proprietors of Joe Schmo's Kitchen. And you have got spices and jellies and peppers, and all these are your recipes that you two developed.
Yes, we do. We actually, a lot of them started out with their family recipe with their grandfather a long time ago as growing up as kids, and kind of turning into our own thing as we progressed and got older with it.
Now, I know you have always been a big fan of cooking. Yes. And you spend a lot of time in the kitchen. Now, did you, Amanda, or did that happen after your marriage?
I'd say probably before we got married, I started getting into cooking more. I cooked before, but not as much as I do now.
And, you know, the beauty of these ingredients is how you simplified it.
Yes.
So even like, you know, it's cooking for dummies, basically. I mean, if you really like Italian, if you really like certain spices, you have really made it so easy for people to have really quality food with just a little bit of work.
Thanks.
And Amanda, I know you've been out at a lot of the farmers markets and selling the products. How's the response been?
It's been really well. We've actually, we just debuted our hot peppers 2 weeks ago, and we sold out, like our first debut of our hot peppers, and we were sold out. People come back, they love us, they order off the line, and we have a good following. So
I mean, I think the hot peppers are really interesting because they're cold packed. Mm-hmm. So you don't refrigerate upon opening. They are cold when you deliver
right.
them.
Right.
Where are you storing all these peppers?
Well, we use the Commonwealth Kitchen Incubator downtown Youngstown. Has been very helpful. They have a setup where we can cook and make our product right out of there and then store them there as well.
Wow, so how is that experience down there? I mean, have you learned a lot?
Yes, we have. It's been a great experience. It's very helpful. Tom Phipps, the manager there, is always there to help you out with whatever you need and point you in the right direction.
I'm gonna have to go down there and do a little segment on that because I've seen that in the paper and you know, on the news. And so it really is helpful for, you know, young entrepreneurs, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, not only do they have the space that you can use and rent out when you need it, but they have a lot of guidance to point you in the places you need for regulations and to be qualified for everything that you have to do.
I am anxious to get started. So we are going to do a couple different things.
Mm-hmm.
And what are we going to start with?
Well, we have a meatloaf here. One of the main things that I learned growing up was that you usually do three things. You do beef, veal, and pork. And we use the 3-2-1. So for every three beef, you have two of the pork and then one portion of the veal.
So this is for the meatball?
Meatball mix, yes.
Okay, so this is about a pound?
About a pound, yes.
All right.
Yep.
And what are we going to add to it to give it the Joe Schmo touch?
Well, we have everything in there. So all we're adding is 2 tablespoons of our all-purpose seasoning.
And by all-purpose, this can go in how many recipes do you have that include this?
Endless. We make potato chips with it, popcorn, grilled chicken, steaks, meatball mix, I mean, salad dressing.
Wow, it smells great. I mean, look at this ingredient list.
So if you want to step it up a little bit, we add breadcrumbs. So I got a half a cup of breadcrumbs, a quarter cup of Parmigiano Romano cheese, and then one egg.
And then you are of the old school where you just mix it by hand.
That's it.
Just I watched you wash your hands, so go right ahead. So you are a meatball baker.
Yes.
Some people are a pan-fried meatball person. So it's always interesting to see, you know, the different meatballs and how they're made.
Well, I feel like I've evolved. I went through a couple of steps growing up, you know, right in the sauce is one way,
mm-hmm.
and then frying them in a pan, and lately I've been baking them off a little bit, so.
All right, how long do you want these in here, Barry?
15 minutes.
All right. And then you're gonna start with the sauce?
Yes, the sauce is real simple. Just take one can of crushed tomatoes, and then again, 2 tablespoons of our all-purpose seasoning mix.
Really? That's it?
That's it. Everything's right in there. Your garlic, your oregano, basil, onion, everything you need.
Wow, that is super easy. And then will you add the meatballs to the sauce when it's ready and it's
yes.
warmed up?
We'll put the sauce on a low simmer, and when the meatballs are ready, we'll throw them right in here and let them cook off a little bit more.
Meatballs, the pasta sauce, and also the salad dressing for Joe Schmo's all-purpose.
Yes.
How do we do that?
So for the salad dressing, you want to take 2/3 cup olive oil, 1/3 a cup red wine vinegar, and 2 teaspoons of the all-purpose seasoning.
And just
mix it up, give it a good shake.
Oh, wow. Excellent.
Yep.
And then you can make even bigger batches and just keep it in the fridge.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, man, we got to start. May I serve you? The big taste test is coming up. I'm sure you've never had this before, Amanda. I hope you enjoy it. A little more noodle for you. Little pasta for you. You get 2 because you're a growing boy. All right, I get some noodles. And I'm dying to try this meatball. There we go. Gentlemen first. Oh, I didn't even know where to begin. We did the sausage, which was super easy. You used ground pork.
Yes, and then just 1 tablespoon of our sausage mix with a 1/4 cup of water. And just mix it together just like a hamburger patty.
That is amazing. That is delicious. I love the peppers. They are still crunchy, got nice heat, locally grown peppers. I love that. They're delicious. Mmm. Thumbs up on that. All right, let me try the sauce. Delicious. Honestly, these meatballs are delicious. Oh my gosh. And I love the dressing too. I love it. So, locally, where can we find it?
We're available currently at Cthulhu's, Rolling Brothers in Austintown and Boardman, and also Bederick's Butcher Block in Mineral Ridge.
Oh, great. And then online, you have a website.
All of our products are available on our website. You can get everything that we have in the local stores and a couple extra products online.
And then you also have recipes in that available, right?
Yes, we post recipes once a week on our Facebook and Instagram pages.
You know, this is great for, you know, senior citizens that hate to cook. And, you know, and it's good for newlyweds. I mean, and you do gift baskets. And
yes.
I'm telling you, let's have a little toast to Joe Schmo's Kitchen.
Thank you.
This is, missed it. Excellent. You have got to check that out. Go to their website. Go to their Facebook. Stop in at the store. Thank you so much. Everything is fabulous.
Thank you.
I mean it. To Joe Schmo's.